So we are doing a little bit of a, or I think it's a fun thing, or a little bit of an interesting thing. You can see I have Haiku over here, and I was messing with it yesterday. I kind of came to this like conclusion, my tiny little brain, is that when I look at Haiku here and look at how it functions, what's going on with it, and the software it supports, the hardware it supports, and stuff like that, I'm like, this is a perfect example of how it was to live with Linux, let's say from 1991 or 2 when it came out, up to like 2004. So if you want to get this feeling of being a Linux user in the 90s and early 2000, run Haiku. This is the stuff we go through with the Linux back in the day. Check for updates here. Let's do that just for the fun of it. Oh, that's already updates. The internet didn't really barely work on it. So we have like a known version of the interweb here, and we have something called Web Positive. YouTube for a long time was a fucking issue on Linux. Hardware support was massively broken on Linux for up to like 2010-ish, was where Linux became plug and play for everything almost. Like you could use it, not a lot of times it didn't work as well as under Windows, but at least you could use the hardware. There were still a lot of performance issues and stuff like that, but at least you could use it. If you want to run Haiku, you need to know your motherboard, the chipset of the motherboard, the CPUs, the GPUs, the network card chipset, the sound card chipsets, and all of those things. Some work, some don't, and you have to basically know what is supported, what is not. That was exactly how it was to live with Linux in the 90s and early 2000s. You couldn't just go down to a store and buy a computer and then like, okay, 90% of this is going to work, or 99% is going to work. No, it was like probably 50% if you're lucky. If you just went down and blindly bought a computer, laptop, and the battery life would be like 30 minutes or something like that. You had to basically specifically build the computer to run Linux. Just like with Haiku, you kind of still have to purposely build the computer to run Haiku. It's a really good example, also just from a UI element aspect of it, because this looks almost identical to how BOS looked like in the 90s and early 2000s. And Linux was not like, this here would not be far from XFCE in the 90s, early 2000s. There were even themes to make it look like this. Like if we, oh, that's the wrong one I'm using there. If we do this, it's a lot like, you know, XFCE. I'm just rearranging them really badly. Oh. Now we have kinda XFCE. You know, you can make XFCE look exactly like this. But this is kind of how we ran XFCE in the 90s, early 2000s. You didn't just buy a graphic card, because even NVIDIA graphic cards, AMD or ATI graphic cards as they were called, not all of the models work. Not all CPUs work. Not all motherboards works. And that is the feeling that you get here. I keep telling people this, that Haiku probably is the new Linux. Because if you really want to go in and get that feeling from Linux, this grassroots up and coming, upstarting, being on the ground and running feeling, you can't get that with Linux anymore. For lack of a better word, Linux is too mainstream for that feeling. Linux is mainstream. Linux is big business. Linux is the state of Linux as it is today can only be done if big, massive corporations with a lot of money supports Linux. That's the only reason it can exist the way it does today. I don't care what you say, it's a fact. So if you want to experience the speed, you know, the output of Linux in the 90s, early 2000s, the community support from Linux in the 90s and early 2000s, try and run Haiku. It's slow to update. It's slow, you know, we don't get many new programs so often. You know, there's a lot of hardware that's not supported. This is how Linux used to be. Some will say Linux in the good old days. But yeah, this is how Linux used to be. And it kind of gives me that little, what will you call it? Nostalgic feeling. running this kind of system here, because it takes me back to when Linux was about this. It was about this. You know, Linux was about the technology. We can even hide names. Oh, cool. And we can sort it by name. Anyway, you know, Linux was about this here. It was about just getting shit done. And yes, it took a long time. We have to wait and blah, 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 blah. But that was how it was. We all knew that. If there came a new hardware out on the market, it would probably take months, if not a year more, before Linux supported it fully on, you know, on a distribution. Some distributions was better at it than others, but a lot of time, like a new graphic card, we were talking years. Or a year, sorry, not years, but a year. That was just how it was. Everyone was working amazingly fast to get what they want up and running. And they didn't have a lot of developers. They didn't have a lot of companies basically supporting it. They didn't have a lot of advertisement or community talking about it and stuff like that. They didn't have a lot of that. They just did their fucking shit. They just worked on it. Just like with Haiku. Nobody really talks about Haiku. Nobody really cares much about Haiku. Nobody really, you know, go out and change the world with Haiku and all these kind of things. It's just a select, tight-knit little community that do their best to get or to make a really good operating system in their eyes. And that was Linux in the 90s, early 2000s, exactly like this. Did we talk politics? Yeah, a little bit. Did we go in and debate each other? Yeah, a little bit. But in the end, it was just about, oh my god, we need to get GNOME better, we need to get KDE better, we need to get the kernel better, we need to talk to more developers, we need to talk to more hardware vendors to get Linux to support us more and stuff. It's just like with everything. In the beginning, it's about the thing. The bigger it becomes, now it becomes about the bottom line, it becomes about the politics, it becomes about the name Linux. And that's what Linux has become now. Linux is probably more run and fueled by politics than Microsoft, Apple, or Windows, Apple, and any other operating system, which in my opinion is the worst thing ever. I'm sitting here, I'm just doing random shit while I'm talking to you guys. I'm like thinking back to getting Doom 3, I think it was called, to work under Linux, and how I had to copy the whole DVD into a specific folder in a specific path in the Linux file tree, and then download or install a zip file that has some third-party code in it that then made me being able to play Doom. And playing Doom 3 when that came out under Linux was like, you could play like a handful of fucking 3D accelerated games on it. It was like, oh my god, you can do that. Nowadays we have Proton, you know, which is not as good as running natively on Windows, but it plays a lot of games. You don't have to think about all of these things. But again, you still have to do that with Haiku. I honestly believe and think that a lot of people that are in this whole fucking Linux world and are too caught up with the politics, the ethos, the philosophies, and all of these fucking crazy things, Go and run Haiku. You know, go and run this fucking system here. I can't seem to do this. Oh, it's up here somewhere. Where is it? There it is. You know, go run this little thing here, and you will be amazed at how it takes you back. I know my brain is overtaxing, thinking, talking, and playing a memory game overload. But you get what I'm saying here. It's. I honestly think it's a healthy thing to experience. To go in and let's install. I don't have a battery, but anyway, you know, if you want to understand what someone like me that has been using Linux for 26 plus years are talking about, when we are talking about all of this that you seem to say, oh, they don't know what they're talking about, that's not Linux and blah blah blah, run Haiku. Listen to the Haiku developer, or not listen, but go into the Haiku forums and stuff like that. Go and see the content creators that do Haiku content, how they think, talk, and use Haiku. It's almost identical identical to Linux from the beginning to like the mid-2000s. That's what people like me are talking about. We like all of the conveniences, the plug and play, and that you don't have to go into the terminal to just fucking mount a USB device anymore. We love that shit, don't get me wrong, we love it. There is something that's gotten missed, because when Linux became easy to use, or too easy to use, you didn't have to think so much more to run it. Even Arch, like, Arch Linux is easy. I don't give a fuck what you say. Arch Linux is fucking easy. Like, give me any fucking dude or dudette on the earth, I can teach them to install and run Arch. It's not that fucking difficult. But there is something, like, when you run Haiku, you still have to think. You still have to think about what's going on, what am I running it on, what are the limitations. I'm running this in VirtualBox. The resolution VirtualBox is a bitch to set up, so I just run it like this in basically old CTR resolution mode. This is what we did with Linux. Like, there was a lot of resolutions that were not supported with Linux back in the day. Sometimes you had to run at a lower resolution because your monitor was not properly supported. Your fucking monitor. Because my monitor is not properly supported, I can't run it at 1080p or whatever the proper resolution is. You get that feeling with Haiku. I am a massive BOS fan. I used and loved BOS when it was relevant. I wish that BOS has taken over the world and blah blah. I could talk for fucking decades about how BOS is the perfect system, even though nothing is perfect. So I like running Haiku because it takes me back to the BOS days, but I also like to run Haiku once in a while because it takes me back to Linux, when Linux was Linux, when Linux was about Linux, when Linux was about technology, when Linux was about being a nerd, helping, exploring. Nowadays, most Linux users have never opened a fucking source code in their life, or piece of code in their life. Back in the day when Linux was like that, almost every Linux user had to fiddle in a code at some fucking point. It's more important to use the right distribution, with the right package manager, with the right right universal package format. That's way more important nowadays than just get shit to work, get shit better, helping out. If those hardcore Linux users, they got into this here and they experienced this, for just run it for a day. Don't run it as your main system, but open it up for a couple of hours and mess around with it and try and do what you want to do and are doing on your Linux machine today. Try and do the same shit, you know. I don't even think I can record anything, you know, because I don't have a sound card in there. Try and do those kind of crazy shit and it will become really, really easy for, or really, really understandable for you, that all of this politics and all of those crazy fucking shitty things is meaningless. There's too much that needs to be done for us to sit and bitch and moan. And that is where someone like me comes in, that tells everyone to just shut the fuck up. You know, get shit done. Like, if the distro troops and the Luke Smith and mental outlaws of the world were spending more time helping people fix Linux, helping people review code, helping people submit bugs, Linux would be in a way better place. If you're one of those Linux users that care about Linux and are interested in the Linux history, I will recommend, do like me, install Haiku onto a virtual machine and mess around with it for an hour or so. Better yet, find a old laptop or old computer and install Haiku on it just to see if the hardware fucking works. And if it's not, can I get it to work? How do I get it to work? Can I do some of the day-to-day things that I want to do on my hardware? That will give you a really close idea about how it was to be a Linux desktop user in the 90s and early 2000s. Not 100%, but fucking close. Haiku is the new Linux. Haiku is what Linux used to be. Running Haiku is like stepping back into Linux past. And it's really, really, really interesting to do that. You will probably appreciate Linux way more if you do what I just talked about here. You will probably even appreciate other operating systems way more if you try to do the Haiku thingy here. Probably will even appreciate Haiku way more. Haiku gave me that Linux feeling. It gives me that this is how I remember Linux. This is Linux. Not the fighting, the politics, the this here. Getting shit to work. Figuring out how shit works. Going and see what the developers are doing and how they are fixing it and helping them out if you can. It's an amazing thing, and I can't recommend it highly enough, especially if you're new to Linux and you want to know what some old fart like me is talking about. This is what we are talking about. This here. There was so much work to be, and there still is a lot of work to be done on Linux, but back then there were even more work to be done on Linux that we didn't have much time to sit and bitch and moan. It was like, do shit, do fucking shit. And if you bitch and moan too much, get the fuck out of here. We need to do shit. This is not a coffee club. You know, we're not sitting in a fucking coffee shop having a Bengals and a Bengal or what it's called and a cake and talking about our feelings. No, get fucking shit done. That's the feeling you will get with this here. And I think that has been lost within Linux. Haiku made me look into C programming again. Haiku makes me want to learn C++. Not Linux, Haiku. Why? Because there's so much that needs to be done. There's so much potential. Linux has not made me want to program in over a decade. I'm not even joking here. Linux used to make me want to learn programming, but in over a decade, no. Windows have got me into programming way more than Linux have. I'm sorry to say it. And it's because of the politics and my feels and the right distribution and blah, 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 blah. I don't want to deal with that fucking shit. Like, I learned two programming languages in 2023. And I learned them within the first 6 months of this year. I am really close to want to learn how to program for Haiku so I can help out. If I can find the time, I really want to. If you want to get into the headspace that I'm in about Linux, you want to understand what people like me are talking about when we are talking about Linux in the past and how it was like the golden age and all that fucking shit, run Haiku. That will give you a really good idea. And I know most people say, this is too fucking outdated, this is shit, this is too fucking irritating, I can't get my fucking Pornhub to work and stuff like that. Exactly. See you all later. Bye-bye.